Mike O'Mara, Radio Entertainment.
Today's episode of The Mike O'Mara Show is brought to you by our bonus packages. Please go to MikeO'MaraShow.com and click on the bonus banner. You'll get access to all of our bonus content, and even better, you'll be helping out TMOS. So please, quit sucking, and we thank you.
Available on demand every day in iTunes and the Google Play Store and around the world on MikeO'MaraShow.com. What more can we do for you? It's The Mike O'Mara Show.
Cue the music, maestro.
Oh, it's time, Mike. It is absolutely time.
Hi, everybody. 4 o'clock, or in our case, we have become such a tardy organization that we no longer are capable of generating broadcast time. So I've got 11 minutes after 4 p.m. Eastern time in these United States as we celebrate week number 2 of the Mike O'Mara Show cocktail party for all of you, where we invite you to join us, pull up your computer, your smartphone, whatever you want to pull up, and join us for some libations as we have a little happy hour for you with our virtual cocktail party, because Lord knows none of us can roll out to our favorite watering hole or go to our favorite, although I have to say that the elderly are socializing. As I went over to my old house in Cocoonville, there were 3, 4, 5 golf carts and 3, 4, 5 cars pulled up at a lady's house who was obviously having a social soiree. The one thing they say not to do during this time, and there they all were out in front of their house enjoying it. And a little sad, a little frustrating, but that's what they were doing today. And as we speak, if you're joining us for the live video stream, we're looking at Oscar and Shannon, who Shannon appears to be wiping down the bar. And yeah. is Shannon going to be enjoying a little red wine today?
Are you drinking red wine, Peach? Or she's drinking Tito's. She says she's drinking Tito's.
I see.
I hold in my hand.
Look at that.
A margarita from Iguana Mia, ladies and gentlemen. How did it hold up after 3 days in the refrigerator? Let's see. Oh, yeah. Oh,
is it okay?
Yes.
Is it okay?
Ooh, that's great booze.
Mike, no one corking fee.
Do you have that thing?
I do.
Is there a corking fee at the O'Maras?
That's good booze.
There it is. There it is. Oh, that is okay. I'm used to having them frozen, but I enjoy these on the rocks. That's just fine. So Carla's grabbing hers, and we are off and running. Rob Spiewak, what are you enjoying today?
Kirkland Cabernet. I'm about to uncork it.
Oh, you are the
He's on brand. He's on brand.
He is. Right. Why can't we get a contract from his favorite?
It's what I had in the cellar, Walmart.
I got this from Target or anything like that. There you go. Are you still going to Costco during this time?
I haven't been in a long time.
Do you miss it?
I do. But you know what? They miss me more.
I'll tell you something. I got a prescription that I have to
for some
pick
cowbell?
Up. No, the cheapest place. When I got, they said, search around, find the cheapest prescription. The cheapest one was at Costco. So I got my prescription filled, and now I'm empty, and I need another one. And it's not life-saving. It's just mood-altering. Mm-hmm. And I have to pick it up at the counter at Costco, and I feel as though I'm going to be running a death gauntlet down here in the great state of
Florida.
Go
prepared, Mike. Go prepared.
I don't have gloves. I don't have
Amazon's
gloves.
Doing a fantastic job. We just ordered these 2 days ago. So
really?
Yeah, they'll get to you.
Well, that's good. There's a bit of a style to them too, with the black gloves that you have on there. Did you order them in that color?
That was what was available. The black gloves give off two, especially with my current dress, two options: either infirmed or that of a criminal element.
Yeah, my mom has been watching the live feed, and she says Oscar's gloves make him look sinister.
I like the gloves. I think they really do make him look evil. Truly evil.
This has a lovely nose on it. Letting it breathe for a moment.
That's just ducky. That's fantastic. And Oscar, you are enjoying the Jack Daniels and Coca-Cola today.
I'm back,
today.
Baby. I'm back. Coke
it,
Zero.
And it's Jack and regular. Oh, it's Coke Zero.
Coke Zero.
Enjoying.
Coke Zero. Coke
Rob,
Zero.
Let's take a look at your wine. Let's see it up against the light. And why don't you tilt that down a little bit so we can see the tannins in it. And if you lean that up to the edge of the glass, we can maybe see the even see the legs if you try to Ooh, get yes. some legs on it. Now, do you know how to get legs on a glass of wine?
Is that when it has it leaves a little residue on the wall?
Yeah, you,
side
so
of the
you
glass?
Take it all the way, you tilt it all the way up almost to the brim, and then you bring it back down. Like
spill
you
on
do
your
it
board.
Towards you or to towards the camera. Yeah. And now you bring it back down. Now you can turn that side. Yeah, do it that side too. And let's take a look. Can we see the boy, that camera's so good.
Seems to be a double amputee mic.
Yeah, no legs on this.
What is the brand of wine? What type of wine?
Mike,
it's Kirkland, but what is it? Is it Cabernet?
It is Kirkland Cabernet Red, yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay, all right.
Sauvignon. Cabernet,
no. That's Sauvignon. That's wonderful. And so have you taken a sip yet? Here we go.
You know what? It'll what? Do in a pandemic.
Now, the important thing that I noticed, though, I couldn't help but noticing, hold up your bottle.
Yeah, let's
hold
see
up
that
the
thing.
Size of his
Look. Oh my God!
Look at the size.
It's cartoon
size. He's got the atomizer jug of it
yes.
right there. Mm. Wow, that is fantastic.
This is classic. Let's rate.
Okay, I say this has a vibrant flavors of black currant, Mike, and a touch of cherry.
That's lovely. Lovely.
Let's rate the alcoholism. Just generally the way we prepped. Mike
All right.
went to a. He basically went completely boutique. He found the one thing you can't find at home, which is the margaritas that are only made in a restaurant. He had them. He did all the. He went through all the proper COVID-19 protocols.
Right.
So he got his. So that's it's a little bougie of you, Mike, but you got what you needed.
Yeah. Right. Now this is also Carla. When did we do this? Did we? Carla's having a seat right now. And do you want your pillow or not?
Yeah,
you want your pillow? Look at her. My house is filled with pillows that are like this.
Similar.
That's, right.
Oh, that's my, terrific.
My house is filled with Chewbacca pillows.
Looks like the set design for Hannah Montana.
Yeah, it's very, very exciting. Are you going to sit down, please?
It's a tight space.
Well, Mike, I can move over.
I think our wives don't understand that when we're broadcasting, them adjusting after we've started the show doesn't help the show.
That's the idea. So,
hey, right. Now listen.
All right, that's it. Now, when did we get our iguana, Mia? And be careful with that. Be very careful.
Oh,
spilling margaritas on
no,
a board.
No, that's not really where I would go with
don't
it.
Help.
That's
at
not
least it's
I
not, Mike. At
it.
Least it's not a sticky drink.
I go that way. Here, take your microphone here. Take the microphone here.
Oh, this
put
is
the
great.
Drink over there.
I that's can't believe perfect. This is actually happening.
That's it. Put the drink over there. There you go.
I hope I don't spill it.
Well, I mean, if you spill it over
if
there,
I
it
do,
doesn't matter. If you spill it
yeah,
here,
there's no need to spill it.
That's why
no,
I always, you know, I'm an experienced on-air drinker. I've
of
been
course.
Doing it for many, many moons.
Have you ever been like to the casino and you're playing cards and you're the one that spills?
Hold on. I gotta turn your
mic oh, I've done
on
that.
Card
I did.
Table?
I right did that this past Vegas show. It was embarrassing.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, like at the blackjack table.
That,
yeah.
I did just got in a car accident though. My motor skills weren't as they are today.
Let me just say that the show's going to be fun. We have absolutely nothing prepared, which means we're going to completely wing it. Which, by the way, as they call in the business, kind of working without a net.
Right.
Where we don't have anything really prepared for it, but we do have the phone lines, which are going to be... Now, what is... Shannon, what are we doing? We're doing a show here.
This is what
she's
I'm talking
so
about.
Fidgety.
It's like... Well, hold on. I got to
turn her microphone
unmute
on. Turn her microphone on.
What?
I got to be prepared.
For what?
Wait, now, what
Anything.
Is this? What
you
is
can't
the, what
get
is...
on the computer and do admin work while we're doing the show.
What are you saying? YouTube,
we can't. We cannot be on air and then her have her computer out and start working on her computer.
What are the odds of tightening up your shot for Carla and me so we can see your faces a little better?
Okay,
yeah.
I got
you're
you.
Kind of far away and over to the left.
I was
you know
be like
that?
Rob.
Mike, I was looking for some
Yeah,
back...
look at Rob. I can see every single blemish on Rob. All right, there we go now.
If only there were one.
I was looking for some help from you, Mike, up, and you just decided to make
yep.
it all about you.
Pan
and then over here.
I can do it.
I got it.
Nope, other way. There you go.
Perfect.
There you go. Now down a little bit.
Hold on. I'm just zooming in a little bit.
That's better.
That's nice.
Yeah. Here we go.
Oh, there you both are.
Thanks.
Right,
Shannon, you look very pretty.
Oh, thank you.
I love your hair. It's gotten so long.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Look at that.
Right,
I'm losing my hair.
No, you look great. I can't believe
how
chic you are.
I guess I'll be back in a little bit.
Yeah, well, that's we're just
come
letting them, you hear me doing it? I'm just letting them have their moment. That's what they're doing. They don't get a chance to hang out until
girl
we're
power.
Unless we're in Las Vegas or something like that. So now I was going to promote the fact that we have phone calls again today. So 888-920-MORE 888-920-6673. Maddie, Madeline, how are you?
I'm great. Glad to be here.
Are you enjoying an adult beverage this afternoon?
Not yet, but I plan on it very soon.
Okay. It's perfectly legal.
I'm so sorry to interrupt, but this margarita is freaking fantastic.
Yeah, it is good.
Oh, my God. Yeah. I am really enjoying it.
This is really... Hey, by the way, these two glasses, was that just one of the containers?
No, we still have a little bit left.
Yes!
Thank you, great.
Jesus.
How many containers did you have to start with? Okay, all right.
$40.
Mike, I would like...
$40.
Worth every cent.
You're helping small businesses out.
Exactly.
Why not?
And since you're having margaritas...
Yeah, you got to tell them the story.
I got to tell you, just real quick, I'll forget it, Rob. I don't mean to interrupt you, but we get the margaritas, and Deidre, who is the manager of Iguana Mia, and a friend of ours, we've been there so many times now, and you know how you become a friend with a regular restaurant you go to? And so Deidre's at the window, and so, hey, how are you? And it's like old home week, and she's hanging out the window. She's like, out of her mind. She's had to let go staff. It sucks to be in the restaurant business right now. So we're having this giant order like we would normally get at the restaurant. And we go through the line, and it's like, hey, how are you? Hey, it's great. Okay, well, listen, well, here's your stuff, and the margaritas are in the container. I said, it's not the same, but it'll be great. And then Carla says, all right, hand me your wallet. And I had $100 in my wallet in cash. I had $100 in cash in my wallet. And I see Carla go, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20. And we start to roll again, and I'm like, bye, Deidre. And this is exactly what I was like. I'm like, see you later. Thank you very much. How much was that?
I know. So we look at the receipt and we see a tax of $40 and we're like, oh, they accidentally taxed us.
Yeah.
What?
Santos.
What are you
doing?
We can't have you ever in studio again.
That was so beautifully mic'd, though. That was so beautiful.
Good dog bark, yeah.
Can we put Santos on camera? Is there a chance
Shannon,
we can
you
put
pick
Santos
him up? He wants
camera?
To go on camera.
Remember, all bets are off on this. And to make a long story short,
Mike wants
We waited. I feel like a dictator. Mike would like to see the dog, please.
Yes.
His honor would love to see the dog.
The dog is coming into frame as we speak.
His Eminence would love to hear another.
Here
bark.
We Here we go.
I love his color.
Look at
he's
Sam.
Good
look at
boy.
How big. Oh my God. He has gotten so big.
Oh my gosh.
And yet still a lap dog.
Tell me that he sleeps with you at night.
He does. He sleeps.
Awesome.
He sleeps right
how
next to us.
Fun to cuddle.
What a beautiful, beautiful animal. Hi, Santos.
Say hi, Santos.
Oh, you are gorgeous. Oh,
he's quiet.
What a beautiful dog.
Yeah.
Please help me.
The reason
so bored.
All right, you can put him down. You don't have to. There he is.
He's a good boy. Good boy.
What a wonderful dog he is. Awesome. Oh, my God. All
so, right, Mike, since you are having margaritas, I would like to suggest sort of, you know how good parties sometimes have a theme?
Wait a second. We never got the $40. So what was the story?
Oh, yeah, I was wondering.
So we sit there and we're going, we said, thank
Let's
you. And
back.
I'm like, why is that much money? So I said, go around. We're not proud. We're going to go around and find out. And she said, oh, that wasn't tax. That was the margaritas. And then I did this ounce by ounce count. Mm-hmm. So these would be the equivalent of two, which at our restaurant would be very inexpensive relative to
60 ounces, right?
We got two 30-ounce containers.
We got one 30-ounce for you and 30 ounces for me.
So, I weigh a lot more than you.
Yeah, but they hit us at the same time.
Yes. Well, Gracie.
One and a half, and boom, we're in our sweet spot.
Here it is. We go back, and she says, no, that was the margarita. And we're like, oh, sorry. And we're not going to challenge her during this time when she's hanging out of a drive-thru window at a restaurant that's normally elbow to elbow. Mm-hmm. And so we figured out, didn't we do a count with the little margaritas they serve, which are... Mm-hmm. What the hell's that?
Oh, Shannon's porn. Shannon's porn.
I was hearing that was it. Those mics are wonderful.
Yeah.
They pick up everything.
Yeah.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
And so we figured it out that when we get our margaritas at Mia, they're $5 each. Right?
Okay.
Right.
And so that would be the equivalent of
two.
Two.
I would say that's two.
So would that be like a
so that's
six
five,
ounce?
10, 15, 20, 20. Yeah, about $30 30 ounces. Yep.
Dollar an ounce.
Mike, it's
if those statistics are true, yes.
No, but if that was true, it would be $60 for the booze.
Well, she just said $30 for 30 ounces. What
we
is the ratio?
We got 2 30-ounce containers.
So 60 ounces.
For about $40.
For $40. So that's about 75 cents an ounce, I think.
So like
which is not bad, right? Right?
Yeah, $10 a drink. City dollars. And then the drinks, they're bootleg drinks.
Yeah, they are.
They're really good.
What do you mean they're bootleg drinks?
Like, you're moonshining now. This is great.
Yeah, you
it's perfectly legal, though. The new law is there, you know, able to...
I agree. I guess what I'm saying is there's no real incentive for them to do this except for just to continue servicing. They could do food, and it'd be much easier. So
they're doing food and booze.
Yeah, which is
great. But food is not. And Mike, the actual answer is 67 cents an ounce if you round up.
Thank you, Rob.
So which is, I think, still a terrific bargain for a drink that's this damn tasty.
And also one that is portable and potable and also refrigerator friendly.
Absolutely. It's delicious.
Time, when are you guys coming to Florida after the virus?
Well, probably in the next couple days.
Okay.
Let me give everybody the phone number. It's 888-920-MORE. 888-920-6673. We will be taking your phone calls.
And Mike, I would like, if possible.
What is she doing now? What is she doing?
This is what I
agree. I agree with her. She's right. She wants it to be perfect.
Yeah, but when we're on the air,
Senorita Fidget.
Can I see the remote? And I'm like, we're on the air.
I apologize because I didn't realize that we were on the air yet.
That's how wonderfully spontaneous and natural this show is that nobody really knows.
People
that
can see your real side, Mike. Everyone thinks I'm the monster.
Mike,
how dare you?
I would like to suggest, if possible, today, because a good party can sometime have a theme. I suggested this to you, I believe, off air yesterday. How about today is a Polynesian cocktail party?
You want to start that again? Fingers, do you want to start
that
again?
Yeah, it took a little while to get
into it. Because it really should come in like clear.
Okay.
In many years, people are going to say, what do you remember about the pandemic? I'll say, it's the time that we slowly debuted the entire score of South Pacific, one song at a time, on the Mike O'Mara Show.
And is Happy Talk from Bally High, too?
That is also from South Pacific, yes.
Can you play Happy Talk? Do we have that one?
Happy Talk, keep talking, Happy Talk.
The theme that we have.
About things you like to do.
All right, there. Is that better?
Yes.
Beautiful.
Fantastic.
All right, fantastic. I'm going to save that. And Maddie, does the shot look okay for our live stream?
I would maybe go out one or two clicks.
Okay, all right. God damn
it. Yeah, Mike always likes the camera up close. I can't stand it. Just saying.
That's because I'm so damn good looking. Rob, let me get this done. Maddie, good?
Love it.
A little less headroom.
That's perfect.
A little less headroom, please. By tilting the camera.
That's perfect.
Right there. Yes.
I love
it. So I'd like to say to everybody that the phones are open today. We're going to do it like we did it last week. Is that right?
As long as you don't turn on us.
Exactly. Let's have this conversation right now.
We're all friends. So we love each other. We respect each other.
Yes.
Right, please explain. Are you talking about last week?
Yeah. As long as you turned on us when the calls went south and you started yelling at us and blaming us. Yes.
I know I did.
Be on your best behavior.
All right.
No guarantees.
Mike, you are the host, and that's what a good host does.
I know. He turns on people.
No. He makes a lovely environment for the guest.
Yeah, and last week I turned on some of the callers. Is that what it
was?
Not the callers.
A little bit.
Did I turn on the call? Well,
I would say it wouldn't be too far or a stretch to say everybody.
Yeah, the world.
I turned on everybody.
Yeah,
I turn on everybody last week?
No, yes.
I don't need the look. You can tell me he's telling the truth without giving me the look. I don't need the look.
The look. Don't give him the look.
I got the... Yeah.
Pretty much.
Last week was, you know, for example, did you see Hoda Kotb today when she's doing the interview with Drew Brees and she bursts out in tears? You know, there was no real rationale for that. No. It wasn't anything he said, but he said, we love you, Drew. And she said, we love you too, Hoda. And then she said, thank you. And then she just lost it.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
I watched it and I lost it because I'm watching her and I understand that when you're broadcasting and you're trying to do the happy face and then you're living with people quarantined and you're hearing about, you know, death and destruction all over the world, it finally, there are moments where it catches up on you and it surprises you. And for some people that are decent and kind and nice and warm, like Hoda Kotb, it manifests itself in tears where she gets emotional. And in places like the Mike O'Mara studio, it manifests itself where I start just screaming at everybody.
So,
Mike, we all deal with crisis. We all deal with crisis in our own ways. I mean, and it's fine. All are in crisis and we have to deal with it.
Now, right now, I'm not going to yell, but I'm going to give a little lesson here.
Sure.
Right there. That's the other. If you're like this, no one's going to hear you. That's the way it's supposed to work.
I don't want to put my lips on the thing.
All right, then I'll take this off. Oh, boy. Okay.
That's close. Better.
All right, did she sound better now without
the
mic?
Yeah, she looks better, too. It's good.
Okay, well, she looks good all the time. So I will.
That's not true. You should have seen me before I showered. It was
but
bad.
I think when he said she, he was referring to the microphone, weren't you?
Oh, yeah.
Sure, we'll go with that. and now my phone's blowing. So the calls today, I'm looking forward to it. I'm looking forward to our regular callers, the people that call all the time. That'll be fine too. I promise I will be on my best behavior today.
Mike, I'm gonna let you pivot to Maddie at any point to ask her if there are calls because right now they're locked. But I'm gonna let you drive the way you usually drive, and she will answer.
This is just like last week.
So you're not involved, but I don't know. I can't communicate with Maddie visually.
She listens
and
to
so
you.
So I
right
don't
now.
Want to. Well, didn't we say last week, Rob? We didn't want a David Edgar moment. Is that what it was?
What about what if I had a light in the studio that I turned on when there were calls and I turned off when there weren't?
Ooh, good idea.
Why don't you just text me when there are calls?
I have a light. I have a light.
Yeah, but a light. I don't need. You know,
flashlight.
Okay.
You can't see it. Never mind.
That works. Right. No, we can see it.
Or Oscar, you could just hold up. A few fingers.
Yeah.
And just as an
I'll
indicator.
Just go like this.
Yeah.
Since we still have some semblance of decency here and order, and we could actually start the show and I could read the first spot the way I'm supposed to.
Okay.
It's the Mike O'Mara Show. You can listen to the Mike O'Mara Show at www.mikeomarashow.com.
Stay tuned for an outstanding entertainment program.
It's the Mike O'Mara Show.
Let's get down to business.
From the entertainment capital of the world.
Don't do that. Please don't
Brad,
do that.
Can you cover me in red vegetable?
Okay. May I help you?
Yes. This is not the best breakfast I ever ate, and I'd like my money back.
I believe you have to fill out a form for that.
No, I'd like my money back now.
I'm sorry, it doesn't work that way. You see, I have to fill out a form, and, well, you ate most of it already, so...
You see that sign? It says 100% guaranteed. You know what the meaning of guarantee is? Did they teach you that here?
Sir, if you just wait a minute.
Look, just put your little hand back in the cash register and give me my $2.75 back, please, Brad.
Sir, if you just give me a minute, I'll find the forms. I'll take care of everything.
I don't have a minute. You've made me late enough. I am so tired of dealing with incompetence. It says 100% guaranteed, you moron.
Mister, if you don't shut up, I'm going to kick 100% of your ass. Is there a problem here? Can I help you, sir?
Dennis. I bet you have a problem. Your employee here used profanity and threatened me with violence. I'm surprised. I eat here all the time and usually have good service until today. All I wanted was my money back on this breakfast. It was a little undercooked. And he threatens me with violence. Now, I'm going to call your supervisor.
I can take care of it. Mr. Hamilton? Did you threaten this customer or use profanity in any way? Well, he insulted me first. He called me a moron, Dennis.
Answer me. Did you threaten this customer or use profanity in any way?
Yes.
You're fine. I'm very sorry, sir. I'll refund your money right now. Hope you won't hold this against us. You know how these young kids are these days. Here we are. Perhaps another breakfast.
I hope you had a hell of a piss, Arnold.
Alan is telling when to break up with a girl like that.
Well, me and Lisa have been going together for 2 years. I love her and all. I mean, she's great in bed. Just that I'm a single, successful guy.
It's the Mike O'Mara Show. Mike O'Mara, Rob Spiewak, Oscar Santana. And now, from his easy chair, here's Mike.
Welcome to the Mike O'Mara Cocktail Party for our live taping today, live streaming all over the world to you, so you can have a virtual little cocktail party. We're
sure.
having one. We hope you can join us from our Podcast Village studios. Also, Leesburg, Virginia, Fort Myers, Florida, and Pony Boy Matt Bloom, who's kind of controlling things from Fairfax, Virginia, probably in his underwear, but we don't hear from him anymore, so we really don't know that. From Sharon, Kansas, to Sherman Oaks, California, Lake Mary, Florida, Warren, Massachusetts, Oakland, Iowa, Oklahoma, Louisiana, the Mike O'Mara Show is on right now and brought to you by Cornerstone. Due to the coronavirus and market instability, mortgage interest rates are now coming off their all-time lows. So it's more important than ever to work with someone you can trust. Call my friends at Cornerstone First Financial. Rates have moved up due to liquidity. So what does that mean? Let me explain it to you. In the first quarter of 2020, there were four times the amount of mortgages written than normally happened in an entire year. So what does that mean? Well, that has caused a shortage in liquidity, so banks are raising their rates to offset the volume in order to slow things down. Classic supply and demand.
Yep.
Luckily, Cornerstone First Financial is in for the long haul, and it's on top of all the latest developments within the mortgage arena. Cornerstone is your source for the... How you doing? You comfortable?
Yeah, I'm getting there.
Okay.
Yes, let's all be dainty.
I didn't need that kidney. Cornerstone is your source for the lowest rates and the best programs. Call my friend Mark Livingstone at Cornerstone First Financial, 202-625-1221. That's 202-625-1221.
Make some way! Make some way!
Jesus, it's tight
over
here.
Can you hear that every time you're doing that,
no.
by the way? Okay, just curious. These rates will get back to historic lows, so call now and get on board. When the liquidity opens up, you'll... already be in line to be locked in and move on to closing. Call 202-625-1221 and see what they can do for you. Cornerstone First Financial, personal attention from application to closing. There is a lot.
I don't hear anything, Mark. I can't hear it.
I have decided that both our spouses on the show are fidgeters. They're both fidgeters.
Mike,
Oz.
You yes. asked for one light, and Shannon came back with tchotchkes.
Shannon's wearing
lights.
A St. Patrick's Day hat. That's wonderful.
I came back with good vibes.
Thank you. Yes. Okay. Mm.
And also half of Angie Goff's props.
Yes.
Yeah.
I've got my Himalayan salt lamp so that I can cleanse the air. You know what I'm saying? I've got... Snoop Dogg candle, you know, light a candle.
Mm-hmm.
Right on.
Light a candle.
Yes.
Very good. Very good. That's
souls.
Exciting.
Fair.
Yes. All right.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I want to say I'm thankful.
Yes, yes.
Okay. And I just thought this was fun and, you know, on brand.
There we go.
Oh, wow, because fair. It's a margarita glass. It yes. doesn't have anything
yeah.
in it, but it's a margarita.
It's fake.
It's a faux margarita.
Oh, faux margarita. Yeah. I got mm-hmm. I got a non-faux margarita.
Yeah. Right now, Mike, I just hit the sweet spot, by the way.
Oh, you did? Oh, you got the buzz. Oh, okay. You got the buzz. We have phone calls,
when
correct?
This light is on, we have phone calls.
What happens when it's off? At 888-920-MORE. That's 888-920-6673. Hello, Mike O'Mara Show. Who's this? And where are you calling from?
Hey, Mike, this is Jacqueline, Sydney, and Charlotte from Aberdeen, Maryland.
Aberdeen! Yay, Aberdeen. The I spent some time on the Aberdeen Proving Grounds two marriages ago.
Jesus.
We actually live right next door to the base, so when they do all the bomb testing, it shakes our house and moves our pictures.
The reason it's called the Aberdeen Proving Grounds, for those of you around the country that might not know this, is because that's where they test what is referred to in the military as ordnance. And ordnance is a very nice, soft word for things that can blow you up real good.
Oh, yeah.
So that's the
correct.
Way they... Well, you are you there with your children right now?
I am. Actually, my daughter's convinced me to call. We're first-time callers, so we're all a little nervous. My daughter Sydney is 9, and my daughter Charlotte is 7.
Woo!
And
we love
I actually
we love
wrote you guys a letter last year, and you read their names on air, and you would have thought that they were famous because they heard their names on the radio. So,
well, they have an opportunity right now to be more famous. If you'd like to put them on the line, we can say hello.
Here, Sydney.
Which one are we talking to?
Hi.
Hi. Hi, who's this?
Sydney.
Hi, Sydney. Are you the 9-year-old?
Yes.
Are you behaving for your mom? Are you guys all in the same house together every single day? And you're not going to school, right? If you're in Maryland, you're not going to school now, right?
Yeah, it gets kind of boring when you're not doing your schoolwork.
I know.
So, Mike, I work from home normally, but they have been, on top of that, I've been having to homeschool them for the past 2 weeks, and it looks like we have at least another four. So I am enjoying red finer than Rob's. It's a boxed red. So.
Hey!
Nice.
Oh, there's nothing only like the a best. Good box of wine. Carla, you can commiserate as far as in these homeschooling times. Mm-hmm. What's the biggest challenge? I know you've been handling that a lot more than I have.
Keeping the kids busy. You know, I try to stick to a schedule as much as possible. I don't always get to everything, but at least it's something that I strive for every day. Otherwise, I would probably go crazy.
And what time of the morning do you start drinking? Just out of curiosity.
I wish like 10:30. Then I have my afternoon nap.
That's right. Good booze.
That's good. So are you maintaining your sanity, ma'am?
No, I'm really not, but Charlotte wants to tell you, I was in a meeting for work today and was unmuted because I was speaking to a coworker, and Charlotte, who is my 7-year-old, is going to tell you what happened.
What happened, Hi, Charlotte. How are you?
Good.
What's happening? What happened when your mommy was on her conference call this morning?
I had a wiggly tooth and it fell out.
Wow! Oh, Charlotte lost a tooth. Charlotte, this is obviously probably not your first. If you're 7, have you lost another tooth before this?
Yeah.
And how much do mommy or daddy, pay for each tooth you lose?
You mean the?
It's probably
tooth fairy?
The tooth fairy that does that, Mike.
Comes. You mean the tooth fairy?
Yeah, oh, the tooth fairy. Yeah.
I've committed a crime.
Yeah.
She's 7. Pardon me for respecting intelligence. What? What's got? What? What? Stop. I don't like having you here today, Carla. You're being difficult. Charlotte, what does the tooth fairy give for a tooth now?
Money.
Money.
Excellent. Cha-ching.
Wow. That's exciting. So, what happened during mommy's call today?
She came running down the stairs saying, "Mom, Mommy, I lost my tooth." And my coworker just started laughing. I'm like, I'm so sorry.
That, you know what? And I apologize for blowing the tooth fairy myth out of the water.
Well, no, some houses the tooth fairy visits. Some houses the parents take care of it.
Yes. But I have to explain.
Right.
When I do the show, thank you for the call, ma'am. We appreciate that. Stay safe
really
up
quick,
in Aberdeen. Thank you.
Can I say something really quick?
Sure.
Yeah, go ahead. Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
So, Rob, I doubt you remember, but last year I wrote in to thank you guys. That's when you said hello to my daughters. But I want to thank you for the advice because my daughter Charlotte actually has leukemia as well.
Oh.
So I appreciate your advice last year. And we love you guys and keep doing what you're doing.
And
I love you too.
I hope she does really well. And so nice of you with the whole family to call. And I hope you enjoy the rest of the show as we live stream. And enjoy your box of red.
Thanks. Bye, guys.
Cheers.
Stay in touch. Stay in touch, please. I'd like that very much. Thank
you.
So
let me explain the way the show goes. So one of my things I do is I kind of say whatever I want to say that with the freedom to do that. And it's really something that is all right. And then Pony's texting me with shtick, too, because he's drinking gin today.
Yeah.
Pony's was kids got to learn the truth eventually. Thank you, Pony.
Damn.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
He's really a sad, dark person, isn't he?
But seriously, the power you have over me is that, so I made that little mistake.
It was a big mistake.
No, that's huge.
No, it's just not as big
that is
as
huge.
Christmas-related mistakes.
We have a 6-year-old that's just in the other room, too.
Yeah, but Mike doesn't raise him. You do. So, look, he's doing the show. He's just doing
I'd just like to know why it's 400 degrees in this studio.
It's the margarita.
Did
for
you
sure.
get warm when you had the margarita?
My ears
or
are
I
warm.
Do I have the COVID?
No, I think what happened is you just got out of the shower.
It's cute
and
now.
You came in
that
here
is,
and
yeah.
you started drinking.
Yeah.
Hey, I got the COVID today. Self-quarantine, we're good.
All right, let's
so,
take
Mike, think
call.
Back to when you were 7 and you were having to deal with the oldest fairy in Glastonbury. You didn't want that ruined, did you?
I didn't want that ruined at all. He lived under a bridge. Now, Rob, I am going to take a call. We're trying to balance the timing of the show. Hello, Mike O'Mara Show. Who is this and where are you calling from?
Your old blind friend Uber driver, Louis Jelly from Culpeper, Virginia.
Yeah!
Louis Jelly!
Hi there. I love when Rob gives the phony enthusiastic response. Hi, Lewis. How are you?
I'm doing great. How are you doing?
I'm wonderful. Rob, can you reacted. Can you give us a background
Lewis,
please?
Lewis Jelly dates back to the terrestrial show. I believe, Lewis, were you not in when we did our literal blind taste test for a cooking segment?
Yes, I was.
Yeah, we had blind listeners come in to do a blind taste test, and Lewis Jelly was one of those guys. He dates back with us over a decade. Lewis, I'm hoping you're doing well.
I'm doing fine. I'm doing fine. I have this thing about this people buying toilet paper with this virus. Okay, now listen. People, it's a respiratory disease, not an aspiratory disease, okay? I mean, why in the world do you have to use corn cobs if you have to, or either get in a shower and wash your ass, you know?
You know what? You know who Lewis
sounds
like?
That's what we're going to be doing soon.
By the way, Lewis is one of our visually challenged listeners and has been listening for a long time. And Lewis, I just realized you sound, when you get all riled up like that, you sound like James Carville.
Oh, yeah.
You sound like James Carville.
Yeah, you're right.
I just want to say, burnish handles on the jump out of the race right now. With his neck and his veins. Well, Lewis, God bless you. How are you doing, my friend?
Doing fine. Listen, what time does your show drop each day?
It depends on Oscar's schedule.
Oh, okay, because I can get you at 1 o'clock some days, and like I can't. And then 8 o'clock in the evening, I have to listen to you.
Lewis, before this coronavirus, we were always available by noon. Bottom line. Now, during this coronavirus, you can bank by 3 o'clock, no problem.
Mention Culpeper sometimes in your towns, okay?
Carla lived in Culpeper.
Yeah, I lived right across from the Walmart.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Yep.
Oh, my God.
Good times. Good times.
That's before I rescued her.
Man, big time.
Great cemetery in Culpeper, too. Great cemetery.
It's so true. It's so true.
That's
before I
floated in and
Yeah, you should have seen me.
Thanks for the call. Thank you very much for the call. We appreciate that. We are here, and we are going to be taking your phone calls from. I'd love to take calls all over the world.
Yes.
Today, the biggest news of the day, I would say, would probably be that the Prime Minister of the UK, Boris Johnson, tested positive with the COVID, and that's pretty intense. So
it shocked me because he looks so healthy.
He does with that mop of hair that he has here. But I'm very excited about Easter Sunday when everything's going to reopen.
Yeah, same here. I can't wait. Carla's countdown is on.
Yeah, I'm buying a seersucker suit. Carla picked out a sundress online.
Man, we're going to eat at every restaurant.
Have you already poured your second one?
Yeah, I am enjoying.
Carla is on her second one.
Wow.
By the way, if you're keeping track at home, that's where I am. Well, let's hit the music because we do have to take a break. And we will take more of your phone calls at 888-920-MORE, 888-920-6673. When we come back, everybody, slow down, Turbo.
They're so good.
All right. Hi, this is Tom Brokaw, a calm, familiar voice in a time of crisis. As we reach the panic stage of this international pandemic, we have a way to defeat the coronavirus. Social distancing. Social distancing. Use a selfie stick. Manipulate your computer with a broomstick. Interconnect a dozen straws to drink your pina colada. Use twin beds for your spouse and your lover. But mostly, stay out of stores. If you need anything, use the shopping banner at michaelmaryshow.com. Target, Macy's, Walmart. It's everything you need from the comfort of your home. Be safe, save some dough, support your favorite podcast, shop, and wash your hands. The soap I use is forget it. Irish Spring. Thank you, Tom. I love that at the end. That makes it. Yeah, that's very bad ego to be enjoying it that much. Anyway, welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show.
I like it.
Brought to you by Lightstream. Ask this question, Carla.
How much money are you paying in interest on your credit cards every month?
How's that?
Thank you.
Too much? Too much margarita.
Then why not consolidate your credit cards into just one payment at a lower fixed rate and start saving money? It's easy with a credit card consolidation loan from Lightstream. And hi, Michael.
Hey, Michael.
Hi,
Michael.
Michael Colburn just texted me. Michael and Nancy are watching.
Oh, okay.
Hi, guys.
Oh, I thought it was little Michael.
Yeah, little Michael.
This is they're regular visitors now with the cocktail party.
I
like that. Consolidate your credit cards into just one payment at a lower fixed rate and start saving money. It's easy with a credit card consolidation loan from Lightstream. Rates are as low as 5.95% APR with AutoPay, so much lower than the national average interest rate of over 20% APR.
Oscar.
Lightstream believes that people with good credit deserve a better loan experience, and that's exactly what they deliver. Check out this actual testimonial. I heard a commercial. Checked into a consolidation loan, and just a few hours later, I had my approval and funds ready to be transferred. Awesome. Tom,
are you broke since you left NBC?
No, I'm just managing my my really high credit card rates effectively. Okay. Just for our listeners, apply now to get a special interest rate discount and save even more. The only way to get this discount is to go to lightstream.com/TMOS. That's LightStream.com/TMOS. Subject to credit approval, rate includes 0.5% autopay discount. Terms and conditions apply, and offers are subject to change without notice. Visit lightstream.com/TMOS for more information. Let's get another phone call because people are calling in, and we're here. We've got Shannon Zaballos, Carla O'Mara, Oscar, Rob, Mike, Maddie's running the cameras, Pony's at home texting. Everybody, the Colburns are listening in. It's wonderful. I love that. Everybody join our stream, and let's take a call. Hello, what is your name, and where are you calling from? Hello, caller. Where are you calling from, and what's your name?
Hello?
Yes, that's you, sir.
Yes, please
we'll try
talk
a third
now.
Time. Hello, what's your name, and where are you calling from?
Hi, Mike.
Hi, what's your name, and where are you calling from? Number four. Number five does not come around very often. Who's this, and where are you calling
You're
from?
You're being nice, Mike.
Thank you.
Yes.
I'd hung up on him. Hang up on him.
No, stop it. My whole goal this week, as far as the callers, was to be much nicer than I was last week, and that's what I aim to do. So, where are you calling from, dumbass?
Sacramento, he says.
Ah, okay. Yes. Yeah, there it is. Well, that answers
Hi,
that.
Rob.
I'm not going to talk to you. You're too quiet and your timing is off.
Into the microphone.
Yeah, thank you, Rob.
All right, what do you want?
I just want to wish my son a 10th happy birthday today.
Oh, a 10th happy birthday, Mike.
Happy birthday.
Who's happy birthday? Who
his son, one? His son. Who's there with him now.
What's your son's name?
His name is Marshall.
Marshall.
Marshall. All right. Mike O'Mara birthday song. Is that good for you, sir? Can we do that for him?
Oh, my gosh. That would be fun.
All right. Okay. On the count of three. One, two, three.
Happy birthday, Marshall.
Happy birthday, Marshall.
10.
Birthday.
Thank you. Hang up on this guy. Thank you very much. Made him happy. That's what.
Oh, by the way, two things, Mike.
By the way, can I just say Rob remembers this from the old days of the radio show, the Sacramento caller?
Oh, it was
yes.
At the very end. Okay,
always.
Well, we have to go. And then as you're hanging up, it'll always be,
Dad, I want you.
Yes. I want you to picture for a second
how
many plates I am spinning in the air right now.
You're doing
okay?
a lot. You're doing a great
Thank
job.
Thank you. What was your question?
Oh, go ahead. I don't have a question. I have
Commentary?
Yeah. Pretty much. So first of all, you buy something, you say something. So by the way, the other day in Walmart, I ordered a bunch of candles. They should be coming soon.
Oh, nice. Through our link?
Yes.
Thank you. You're
Secondly,
lying. That was a lie, but thank you.
That is not a lie.
No, she doesn't lie.
Yes.
So that's true. Yeah,
okay, so secondly, you know that Dial antibacterial soap came in today,
ooh,
right?
Ooh.
So we
right.
have like,
I ordered.
But there, it's Bard soap, by
that's
the way.
It's like a big bag.
Oh.
I picked it up. It was like what they hit
how
private
many?
Pile
how
with
many,
in
how
full
many were
metal
in there,
jacket.
Would you say? Maybe
Can I
30? 30 bars?
Do you need 30? You're hoarding.
I had a really.
No, but I have a point. So I looked at the invoice. Do you know how much you paid for that soap?
Oh.
$40.
That's pretty good for 30 bars, right?
What yeah, it's not
cost?
Bad.
What a soap
that's
cost?
That's exactly
yeah.
the soap
really?
I use.
Sorry, that didn't go as well as planned.
Yeah, yeah.
Sorry.
See, when
I thought you were price gouged.
No.
No.
You're cut off, Carla. You're cut off.
Oh, shit.
Right. So, anyway. They had an option to buy a 30-pack of soap. I said, if I buy this, we don't have to worry about soap for the next year. We'll be fine.
Yeah, you're good.
And it was the option that was available online. When it arrived at the door today.
Hey, wait. Soap should be free.
What?
Bard soap should be free.
Oh, she is S house.
What are you, a communist?
This is great. This is great.
It leaves soap scum all over the bathtub, right?
Here's the thing. I got the package, and what I was going to say, it's like the T-shirt that they beat Private Pyle with.
Sure.
There were loose bars. This was not packaged. Oh. This was somebody who hoarded soap and decided
to put
wrapped. It into a
bag. I mean, they were wrapped, I hope. It wasn't just
they
like...
They were.
Can you get a bar of the soap and show?
I'd love to see it.
Really,
love to see it.
The real quality.
Oh, and it smells really good too.
No, but get one of the ones that's really kind of like damaged.
None of them were. I didn't see any. I put them all away.
They're not perfect though, right? They're a little banged up. They were a little banged up on the
outside. They're not sealed. They're not sealed.
They weren't sealed, and they were loose in the bag.
I don't want to get up
like it.
She says no. That's an affirmative no. Mike, she might not make it back.
Not
she's
worth
probably
it. Not worth
Mike,
it.
Do you know sometimes when you would take a holiday when we had the terrestrial show and I was forced to co-host with Beth Ann?
Right. Oh, yeah. They're very similar timing.
Yeah, timing, and also the way that they would. There's something in radio and improv called yes and. When you ask someone a question, they always agree in the affirmative and then add to it. They don't shut it down. Just a thought.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Rob was just giving you a hard time.
Yeah, red wine.
You're fine, Carla. You're fine.
Yeah,
you're fine.
Yeah. Too bad we all can't be sober like you.
Hey, I actually am. That's not really a margarita.
No,
that's
not.
Fake.
No, she's not. I haven't come close to finishing my first one yet.
And I'm still on my...
And no, you are on your second one.
Second.
Yeah. Yep.
All right. Let's take another phone call at 888-920-6673. We'll try this again. Hello. Who's this and where are you calling from?
Hi, this is Jim. I'm in Prince Frederick, Maryland.
Frederick, Maryland, a beautiful part of the state of Maryland that I think I try to know my states and what they're doing right now, that they've shut things down pretty tightly. Governor Hogan has done that. Is that accurate, sir?
That is true, yeah.
Man. How are you?
I'm doing great. I've been forcibly retired, so I've been home at any rate. So this quarantine thing is just like a regular thing.
So what were you forcibly retired from?
I was a geeky computer software instructor, and the company decided they didn't want to pay people to do that. They wanted to have consultants, so they didn't have to pay medical fees. So I got like laid off, and I do consulting work every once in a while.
And did you get laid off like in conjunction with the corona thing? Is that what happened?
This was like almost 2 years ago.
Are we getting an Amber Alert right now?
Oh, wait, it says
the show?
To prevent the spread of
COVID-19.
Yeah, COVID-19. Oh. Hold on. Lee County encourages residents to stay home this weekend.
Oh, you finally got it. Yeah, we got
We got it.
Well, I'm glad to see Florida really cracking down. Where do they stand on hand washing?
It's up to you.
That's like, sir, thank you very much for the call, and stay safe in Prince Frederick.
Thank you.
We hope you're enjoying our cocktail party. What are you drinking today, sir?
I think he's gone. Maddie cut him off.
Yeah. Sorry about that.
Yes.
All right. I'll try to do hands.
Yeah. We'll be good.
That's fine.
She's watching you as well.
I forget. It's right now. Yeah. Okay. So today in Lee County, which is the county in Florida I live in, they had a meeting scheduled. I believe it was 1 o'clock this afternoon where they were going to make a decision. I guess they made their decision.
That's, I thought they were going to reconvene on Monday.
I don't know.
That's what
kind
I heard
of
last.
Conflicting. But what was the David Spade joke? Or maybe it was Seth Meyers who
which
said...
Which one?
Florida is instituting their what virus initiative.
Exactly, their what virus initiative. That was Spade, yeah.
You know, stellar leadership in this state right now, where it's like, well, no need
the
to
thing that
the
blows
beaches.
My mind, remember the kid that about a week ago was saying, well, if I get it, I get it, but we've been planning spring break for over a month, so I'm here. He actually has taken more proactive action in apologizing than your entire state. He actually is ahead of the curve. Yeah.
His apology, his stupid statement was viral, and he has gone viral with that.
Yes.
It's stunning. It really is. Let's take one more call before we have to break again.
Okay.
I forgot how fast this show moves when we're doing this, but we got a bonus show that's going to be live streamed as well. Hello, caller. What is your name and where are you calling from?
Right.
Your name and where are you calling from?
Derek Murphy from Greenbelt, Maryland.
Hi.
Hi, Carla. You are looking hot again.
Well, geez, thanks.
Dennis, Dennis, have you watched Tiger King on Netflix? Because you belong in that cast.
Stop, Dennis. Dennis, you have to watch that show.
I'm not going to go for this weekend.
Okay. Good. What that's about wonderful. Not eating your phone for this weekend?
Now, that's rude, Oscar. Let me rephrase the question. Dennis, if it is on your schedule for this weekend, what else is on your schedule for this weekend?
Watching television.
That's wonderful. Mm. Thanks for the answer. Dennis, stay safe. That's it. We got to take a break. And okay. Yeah, that's it. God. Maddie. 7 days of torture, 7 days of bitter. Maddie.
Yes.
We have an O. Murphy rule now.
Okay. Good to know.
Thank
good
you
to
very
know.
Much. That's 2 weeks in a row. That is hard on the brain. It really is. But we're doing okay. How you doing, Carla?
I'm good.
Good. Glad to hear it. We'll take a break. I'm going to be nice.
Be nice.
And we will be back with more fun on the Mike O'Mara Show.
My fellow Americans, we've decided as a way to strengthen America, we are going to keep the Yak Shack open, at least until Easter. What a beautiful vision. Imagine all of the TMOS listeners in their Sunday best, shoulder to shoulder, calling the Yak Shack. 888-920-MORE. That's 888-920-6673. Call us. Tell us who you are. Or how you are, or where you are. Get close, but not too close. Cough into your elbow, shop local, think global. No kissing, some handshaking, don't spit much, and don't touch other people's faces. A few deaths will save America. Sad. But the Yak Shack is open. Happy. Let's fight this virus with strength and ignorance. Thank you.
Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show. How you doing, Carla?
I'm good. What did
How
I
you
do? Doing?
You just kind of have to not move around and touch
I
things.
Was,
that's it. That's really...
Are you giving me a hard time?
I'm giving you a little hard time right there. Thank
that's
you.
That's ridiculous.
Carla just disconnected our connection.
Mike, I had
no.
Mad. I had a pep talk with Shannon about the same thing while we were in break with mute. I said, Shannon, when you move around...
Like, seriously, it's like I'm in Montessori school.
It distracts us.
I was going to get you another drink, but I guess I'm not now.
That's
thank
fine
you.
If you want to be like that. Solid burn.
Hey.
Oh, welcome. Face. Welcome back.
Oh, gosh.
Welcome back to the... Welcome back. Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show, brought to you by Honey. I don't even have... the trace of a buzz based on the energy in this room today. Honey is a sweet way to save money. Listen to me, friends, okay? Oh, that look. I'm getting more looks. Honey is the free online shopping tool that automatically finds the best promo codes and applies them to your cart. Saving with Honey is like hitting the lottery because Honey will surprise you with money in the form of savings you're not expecting. Margaritas. Ka-ching. Honey makes you feel like the president of the United States of savings. Winning. Honey has found it's over 18 million members, over $2 billion in savings. Did you know Honey supports over 30,000 stores online?
Hey, Honey, can I have some money?
Thank you, Carla.
Honey gives you money, right?
Yes, it does. Macy's, Target, Sephora, Best Buy, and more. And they're adding more every day. Users love Honey. That's why it has over 100,000 plus five-star reviews on the Google Chrome store. Using Honey feels pretty great. Think of it as a little daily victory, and you're shopping from home, okay?
Home?
Plus, it's free to use and installs in just a few seconds. Get Honey for free at...
joinhoney.com/TMOS.
That's joinhoney.com/TMOS. Thank you, Honey. All right.
Okay. All right.
Colburn,
good
Colburn,
booze.
I think Colburn's buzzed. He's
I don't
he's
think
like,
he drinks.
Nancy are watching your Brokaw is the best on fire. God bless you, Michael.
Yay, Michael Colburn.
Well. Yes, Oscar Santana.
Mike, I would like to take this moment before we get too far into the show, into the bonus show, which, by the way, will be stream free on Facebook Live.
Yes.
For you that want to hang out and continue with the soiree and the happy hour on Friday. Mike, we discussed before the show a type of online store, and you said, let's talk about it on the show.
Yeah, here it is. I'm going to let Oscar take it from here, but I do want to tell somebody, tell people out there that we are How you doing, Wino? How you doing over there? All right.
I didn't say a word.
Listen, I know he's fine because I've seen him drink like three bottles before.
Thank you very much. All right. Here we go. During these times, we are challenged as well. Our business model, by this time, we would have already started ticket sales for our live show. That's how we get through our spring after we had the Amazon problem. And right now, we are having to come up with creative ways to finance the show, to support the show, to keep us chugging along. We have decided to reopen the online store. And to tell you all about that, Oscar Santana, take it away. And then we'll take more of your phone calls.
Thank you, Mike. If you're out there and you're of the show and you can and there's a place for it, please think about coming on board and going to michaelmayershow.com, hitting the t-shirts tab that's right there in the navigation bar, and we have t-shirts and hoodies available now for pre-order in limited edition, so go fast. And thank you to our friend at Bus Tees who turned this around pretty quick. We have t-shirts and hoodies ready right now for order with the logo. And if you have a logo option that you want on the store, we'd love to connect with you. Please feel free to send them to oscar@michaelmayershow.com. But more importantly, right now, we'll start
with the
logo.
Now, is that up right now? Because I'm on the website.
Yes,
I want to make sure
it says t-shirts.
Up.
And you click
Where
through
does it
that.
Say that? Oh, there it is right there. Can we get that a little bigger so people can see that? I had to search
Pony,
for it.
Pony, why don't you
bit,
make it the big banner during the show, if you don't mind? You're listening right now.
All right. This is very, very cool.
Sure, I'd be glad to do that, Oscar. It's just left click and get that going right now. Make it be the big banner.
I love the hoodie.
I definitely need Can you order me a hoodie, please?
Yeah, I'll get you a hoodie right now.
Thank you.
And size?
Medium.
Medium. Yeah. Okay, very good.
Medium.
And that's good. And a beautiful t-shirt. We're going to have more stuff. You know my number one. I want to get hats.
Yes.
I want to get hats and visors if we can.
They are coming.
We're going to add stuff, but thank you to Bus Tees. They are wonderful people to deal with. And anything I'm missing,
Yeah,
Oscar,
just
that's
we had a pre-show meeting about the hats, and we were like, everybody's inside. Why do they need hats right now? They need shirts and hoodies to be
Why
comfy.
Are you wearing a hat?
Let me tell you about that pre-show
haircut.
Meeting. There was only one guy at that meeting.
Yes.
There was only one guy at that meeting, and his initials are OS for the show and OZ in real life. That's the way that goes.
The guy that keeps
he did
working.
It. I didn't. Yeah,
but you got to check back on that site on a regular basis because it's ever changing and there's new merchandise all the time.
For sure.
Oh, sir, may I get up?
Yes, you may.
Okay.
Look at that. My cuppeth runneth empty.
Runneth empty. Mike, you didn't get rid of all your salt. You didn't ration your salt nicely against your liquid.
No, I don't lick the salt all the time on the margarita. I'm not a big
What
salt
if you have a salty dog?
What's a salty dog?
That's gin and grapefruit juice with a salted rim.
Really? That sounds
and by the way, Mike, I want to, you know,
wait,
it is good.
Hold on, Rob. I know you're excited and you're hammered. Do you mind, Mike, muting Carla's mic when she gets up? Because we can.
Oh, yeah,
thank you.
Can do that.
Appreciate it. Thank you very much.
There we go. Thank you.
Mike, a little show and tell. I was almost broke this open for today, maybe for next week's cocktail party. Look what I brought. This is the Ryan Reynolds Aviator Gin.
Ooh.
Aviation Gin.
Aviation Gin. Forgive me for misspeaking. The label was facing the camera, not me. But it's a beautiful bottle. And it is a boutique gin that is actually 42% alcohol, so it's 84 proof. It's an overproofed gin. So maybe Salty Dogs next week. We shall see.
Let's get right back to the phones at 888-920-MORE. That's 888-920-6673. Hello, who's this and where are you calling from?
It's Katie, and I'm calling from Savannah.
Yay!
Savannah. Ladies and gentlemen, the co-host of Cake and Cookies and a wonderful friend of the show, Katie Powers, Sacco and Vanzetti, Von Herman, wife of Dan, radio partner of Rob Spiewak. Katie, this is weird, isn't it? Because, I mean, we've talked during hurricanes and other natural disasters, but it seems like we only get together when something horrible is happening. How are you hunkering down in Savannah, Georgia? How's Georgia's a pretty seriously, what happened? What did I miss?
No, Rob's just pouring, and we're hearing.
Just the gentle has had like 9 glasses of wine already.
No, that's
Rob
a lie.
Like consumed
that's a
half
lie.
A bottle already.
How much do you have left, Rob?
There is 2/3 of that bottle left, at least. Maybe more.
Can you
more.
Hold the bottle up so we can see it, please? All right, there you go.
that's a lie.
Katie, how are you?
I'm fine. I mean, I don't leave my house anyway, so this is...
This is
on
brand.
I don't have a job. I don't have a car. So here we are.
Oh, wow. And you are you watching us on the stream today?
Yeah, of course. Carla, Shannon, you guys are gorgeous.
Oh,
that's very sweet.
Yep.
That's very sweet.
You're the best.
Carla stepped into the kitchen. I'm getting a little well-deserved respite from
her. Are we getting some feedback from a phone?
Oh,
where's that mic at?
Give her a break.
Mic. Mike, I'm sorry. Mike, where's Carla's mic at or headphones? I'm hearing some...
Hello, hello.
Oh, yes. Actually, Mike, if you can hold that up while we... It went away for a second. Somebody mute themselves because we're hearing a huge
buzz. Hold on. All
right. It's Rob. It's on you, Rob. Wherever.
It's me.
Yeah, it's Rob.
Hold on a sec. I'll figure it out.
Thank you.
Started right. When you started pouring your wine.
Yeah, wherever you put your phone and your board, whatever happened.
This is Katie. This is the second week we've been doing this, and it is a work in progress. We're
you
trying to do the very.
Listen every day. I have nothing
to God bless.
Katie,
you.
How's Dan doing in this? Yeah, I know that he's doing his best, but Dan's got to be a little freaked out.
Why?
Because he's got to actually deal with people. You're the shut-in.
Oh, no. He has been told he's working from home for at least 2 to 3 months.
Wow.
Yeah. It's like, well, I mean, Savannah's fine, but Dan works on Hilton Head Island in South Carolina, and it's old people central.
That's true.
Oh, okay.
Now, Katie, let me ask you about that, because I live in the belly of that beast as well. Is he in the midst of people who don't give a rat's ass about things? Because down here, they don't care. They don't care about it. It's obvious to me that a lot of them are not really taking it all that seriously. Is he dealing with the same type of stuff?
Sort of. He was sent home about a week and a half ago. But I will tell you, I went to Walgreens here, and I went to the old people Walgreens. I'm serious. I needed Zyrtec and a bottle of wine.
Sure.
So I went, and I thought it would be empty. The blue hairs were out like it was bingo time. It was 12:30 yesterday.
Yeah, they're everywhere. It's just they're not paying attention. There's a meme circulating that shows the millennial kid playing a video game and his father stepping out.
Yeah.
He says, "Dad, you're not supposed to go." And it's like a reversal of roles. And I'm stunned by it. I'm really stunned that
Katie, do you think it is exclusively an old person thing, or do you think it also has to do with the Savannah lifestyle, which is that of a relaxed responsibility? I mean, it is a party town.
No.
Do you think that's part of it?
I don't, because I will tell. So I will say one of the biggest things here that we have all year round is St. Patrick's Day.
Right.
And they close down the parade. They close
Brilliant.
Down everything. All of the restaurants, you can do pickup, or most of them are they'll deliver. But there's no in dining, none of it. Only essential work. The police will pull people over. Like everyone, their kids are home. They're like losing their minds. It's a whole thing. But the old people out and about, it's like they go through menopause and they just don't care anymore.
Wow. That is awesome.
That is so true.
People. Katie, stay safe with Dan Von Herman
and the dogs.
Really, and the dogs, your beagles. And thank you so much for calling in. We love you. And you take care of yourself, okay?
Love you guys. Love you so much.
Thank you
Bye
so much.
Katie.
Bye, love you, Katie.
Love
Bye,
you.
Deedle.
There she goes. She's wonderful. I have to say this, that today, as much as I'm like shelter in place, and we just got the kind of the formal order, right,
yeah.
from Lee County
yeah.
to stay where we are. We've been doing it. I did make a run to the hardware store today. I made a run.
Yeah, can you believe it? Yeah, tis.
Okay, you know what? Actually, this is on brand for Mike. Mike rode a motorcycle without a helmet for a good 2 years
in Florida.
I know,
right? I know,
so,
and I told him not to.
He does what he wants.
All right.
Yeah, he does.
No, listen. I mean, I'm about to close on this house, and there are just a couple of things. The studio furniture, which was built in, by the way, how's the margarita, Carly? You enjoying
it?
It's
so good.
Okay. built-in furniture. I had to make a few little tweaks to it and get it presentable. Now, could I sell the house without having to do that? Yeah.
Probably.
But you know what? I'm not going to do that.
No
I
risk,
leave,
Mike. No
I
risk.
Wanna,
no risk.
I want to leave there, you know, and I washed my hands. Are you playing something?
Well, we probably should break. I thought you were going to set up a story for
All
the
right.
next break.
No, it didn't even sound like that. You're so hammered. It literally was like he was getting into a topic, not into a break.
No, he was getting into a teaser, Oscar.
You're so wrong, Rob.
Not the first time.
You just tried to push him off the stage.
Thanks for the help, Shannon.
Since he's been at home, Shannon, he doesn't listen to me if he's at home anymore. He doesn't. He doesn't pay attention to the show. It's weird. I don't know what's going on. So I'm now I'm all discombobulated. I went to the Ace Hardware to buy some paint to touch up this furniture that I had, stain, right, to get that, and it didn't work, and then I had to go back once. And so the first time I went in there, I'm ultra paranoid. Now, Carla, please tell our listeners that I have walked the walk, and I have made... I have made two trips to a store.
Right.
You have made two as well.
But you didn't need to go to this store.
Probably not. Probably not.
Ooh. Right. I mean, let's be honest here. Don't ask me to lie.
I'm not asking you to lie.
Tell the truth.
I'm telling the truth.
But I do have to say, though, when he did go to Ace, he did come home with two rolls of paper towels.
Mike, for your family.
Yeah, he found them.
We sanitized, then I washed my hands, I did it. But I didn't tell you the one scary thing that happened at the Ace.
Oh, yeah, you did.
About the lady. So at the Ace Hardware, the checkout, they have giant plastic walls, so you are not dealing, breath to breath with people.
Wow. Oh, so you're separated from the clerk.
Yeah, but I mean, there are two people in the store. I come up there, and why did the lady have to, when I was there checking out, turn and go, why did she have to do that? Why did she have to do that? And I chalked it up to the fact that maybe she's a smoker, or maybe she's got the COVID, and I'll have it by Saturday.
Yeah. Well, we know if you do have it by Saturday,
we'll find out.
Got it from.
Yeah.
But Mike,
and then you'll have a fun show.
You can't miss the show, though.
No.
No, I won't miss the show. I will do that from ICU. Yeah. even if they put my bed in an armory, I'll be there. Now you can hit the music, Rob. Absolutely. You can do that. We'll come back with more fun. More of your phone calls at 888-920-MORE, 888-6673. What is it? 888-920-6673.
Precisely.
That's the first tell. When we come back on the Mike... When we come back on the Mike O'Mara show. On the Mike O'Mara timing show.
The new normal is staying in and staying safe. It can be quite an adjustment. One noted expert has tips on how you can make the most of your time.
Wash your hands, watch TV, and relax and work out at home.
Another great way to pass the time is to enjoy the TMOS bonus show, a 6-hour of top-notch comedy delivered to your computer or phone each week for just pennies a day. Click that banner at MikeO'MaraShow.com and access a library with over 450 shows to choose from. This has been a health tip from the Mike O'Mara Show. Time now to wash some hands.
Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show. There, done.
Yeah,
thank you.
You showed that.
What's going on?
That was the sound of you teaching people how to wash their hands.
Part of the promo.
Okay. I'm sorry.
That's all right.
God. Mike, you're in the sweet spot now.
Sweet spot.
You look a little flush, honey. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. I'm just drinking tequila. This portion of the Mike O'Mara Show is brought to you by our bonus package. Good news, party people. If you're enjoying what you're hearing now, and why wouldn't you? It's top-notch entertainment.
Exactly.
It's going to continue for another full hour after the conclusion of today's regular show. How about that? Isn't that something?
Yes, that is.
Isn't that special?
Yeah.
The MOC...
How about that? Okay, I'm sorry. I'll stop.
You did that on purpose, right?
I did.
Right?
I'm sorry.
The MOCP, that's the Mike O'Mara Cocktail Party, will continue on into this week's TMOS bonus show. But wait, listen to the words coming out of my mouth. Anyone can watch the bonus video stream live. That means you. But after the show, the bonus party goes behind the paywall, so don't miss your big chance. Get ready to stick around for bonus fun and bonus booze. Booze!
Booze!
Boo, that's
great!
Booze! Yeah, by the way,
that's good booze.
By the way, while you're cooped up in your house, please keep in mind that there are nearly 500 commercial-free, uncensored bonus shows available to you for just pennies a day at MikeO'MaraShow.com. It's good stuff. And now would be a great time to subscribe, just saying. It's your passport to the assport.
Assport.
Excuse me.
Oh, dear. I smell lime.
Copyright 2020, the TMOS bonus show. Thank you, Brett. Shannon, how are you doing over there with your candle and your Irish hat and everything else?
Great, but Oscar just told me that he busted ass.
Ew, I didn't think you farted, Oscar.
I do. I do. I said,
he
hey,
normally.
Hey, there's a lot going on. It's coming. It's coming your way. It's coming your
are
way.
Are you nervous? Does your
yeah, no, my stomach hurts.
Nervous?
My stomach
he's
hurts.
5,000 shows here. He's not nervous.
No, no, I'm just saying maybe something's
into
going
the
on.
Mic,
I'm
into
just
the
saying
mic.
Maybe something's going on, Oscar.
Well, I'm
I mean.
Nervous the mic's about to turn.
Oh.
No, I'm not going to turn.
No.
I'm not going to turn.
Are you sure?
No, I'm really not. Carla, I know Carla's working me. I know that's what she's trying to do. She admitted it like during the break. There,
now you're
right?
blaming me?
No. But are you trying to...
Huh? Huh? Huh?
Mike, do you see this light on? This light is great.
888-920-MORE. 888-920-6673.
Subtle, isn't he?
Let's take another phone call. Hello, caller. Who's this and where are you calling from?
Hi, this is Scott from California.
What part of California, Scott?
Hi, I'm calling you guys because I got some really good news. I used to listen to you guys.
Hey, Scott. Scott, I'm sorry.
Yes?
It's a throwback to when I used to do the live show. You know, when a direct question is asked, it's just I have to have an answer before we can move on. What
right.
part of California are you calling from, Scott?
Fairfield.
Fayetteville.
Where?
Fayetteville.
Fairfield. It's close to Davis.
Oh, Sand Hill. Sand Hill.
Sheffield.
No,
Sheffield.
What I'm hearing... No, I'll tell you what I'm hearing.
I heard
hearing.
Los Angeles.
I'm hearing...
Sheffield?
Is it Sayfield?
No, it's Fair, like F-A-I-R.
Sayfield. Sayfield.
Where's Sayfield, California?
It's about 20 miles from Davis.
Where's Davis?
Okay. So it's Northern California.
Okay.
Northern California.
Sacktown.
Yeah. What can we do? What can... What can we do for you, Scott?
Well, I got some great news. I used to listen to you guys 3 days a week in dialysis. And I got a call on Monday saying that UC Davis has a kidney for me.
Yeah!
I had a kidney transplant.
Yes!
I had a kidney transplant on Tuesday.
Attaboy,
great news!
Awesome.
Great news!
Congratulations.
How used is the kidney?
It's probably as used as I am. Probably about 50
That is
wonderful.
Great. Are you nervous? And I'm not going to make any joke about it right now at all. Are you nervous about hospital availability with this now? Are they going to prioritize you? I'm sure you have the answer to that.
Yes,
regardless of the situation going on now.
Yes, they did. They did the surgery on Tuesday.
They did the surgery.
Yes, I'm going home today.
Oh, that's
yes,
great.
Yes,
that's awesome.
Yes.
Now, you know, I know a little bit about this because my Aunt Gail received a kidney from my mother. And the person that donates it, it's a more severe surgery for the donation than the recipient. So the fact that you've already weathered the surgery and accepted it, that's great news. You must feel like you're 10 feet tall right now.
I do, yes.
Attaboy, that's awesome.
Let me ask you this. Go ahead.
It had to bring my immune system down to zero,
right.
So I'm really susceptible to anything. So I got to stay in the house for the next 6 months.
Yeah.
That's absolutely true. And by the way, when you had that procedure, at any time during this, were you on a ventilator? Were you actually on a ventilator?
Yes, for 6 hours.
Oh, selfish. Anyway, Oscar, you were gonna say
sir,
something.
One of the best. This is not the CDC issued, recommendation. But one of the best ways to recover from a kidney transplant is in a Michael Mara Show sweatshirt or T-shirt.
Yes,
you can find the T-shirt tab on MichaelMaraShow.com.
I'll get one.
Now, a lot of people don't know
this,
but if you put the hoodie on backwards and then put the hood up. It's like wearing a mask.
Hey, okay.
There you go. Cut the eye holes out and put a string through it.
You're in Fat City, baby.
Scott, congratulations, and I wish you nothing but the best for a speedy recovery. Please keep us posted on your recovery. Let us know, okay?
I will. You guys make me smile every day.
Love.
God
thank
bless
you.
You. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for the call. We appreciate that. So here we are in the throes of this. Would I be... overly optimistic if I said that obviously we have not peaked yet in this country. We certainly haven't peaked in certain parts of this country, but you are hearing areas where they flattened out to a certain extent. Am I right about that to a degree?
Where?
Maybe the state of Washington. I'll give you
some insight, and this isn't confirmed, and this is anecdotal. The idea that we're doing what we're doing. Let's say New England, for example. That's the only, internal inside info I have.
Right.
Is that there isn't enough progress, but there's a little progress. What we're doing is working.
What I'm hearing. That's yes. when I, and then, you know, thank God for that. Yes. So, I mean, look, the reality is that certain government leaders and certain federal leaders and certain governors around the country aren't necessarily going to give you the guidance that that you agree with. But if you want to be safe yourself and overcorrect and you want to stay inside and you want to do what we've been doing, 2 weeks before we were really finally told to?
Yeah, two weeks tomorrow.
I think that's that's good guidance, and that's a good thing to do. Yes, Rob Spiewak.
Here's a question, and this to me is just a gut feeling, again, anecdotal, as Oscar says. Do you feel that the national mood is finally starting to take this a little more serious?
I don't think so. I just based on my personal experience, I think people in America, to a certain extent, react to something when it is literally shoved in their face.
In their face.
And we are living, I think really now more than ever, we live in a world where if you are successful in creating some kind of alternate reality or alternate fact, that people can dive into it and there are people that get off on it.
Yeah.
I believe that. I believe that, you know, give me something where I can go against the people that I don't like. And that's more important to me than facts and what's going on. But thank God for the brave people. Many of them in our listening audience
yes.
that are out there doing it every day and showing pictures of them with their masks on. And Catherine is staying with a friend of hers in New Jersey whose father is an anesthesiologist. And he's on the front lines, chief
wow.
of anesthesiology in this hospital. And it is just, you know, Oscar's family, medical people all over the place. God bless the bravery where
here, here.
I read an article today about these nurses and doctors that are adjusting their wills.
Yep.
They're adjusting their wills. Think about that for a second.
Mike,
that's bravery, folks.
Mike,
that's real bravery.
Think about
yeah,
it this
ahead.
Way. One of our clients is George Washington Hospital, which is a massive, like it's one of the biggest hospitals in the DC area.
Right.
Mm-hmm. They are working hard to just do their best to make sure that everybody knows what people should be doing at home.
Right.
Like, let alone just save, like being on the front lines, making sure that they take on the most critical patients
mm-hmm. right.
and trying to save their lives. Like, everyone right. is working hard.
Time for my demonstration again. So it's neat, 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 do the thumbs, do the thumbs, wrist, wrist, wrist. Wrist, 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 and you're done.
And it's a
there
double.
And make sure to dry your hands.
And
completely.
It's a double whammy because once this is all over, that's great foreplay.
Hmm. Yeah, on this note, Rob Spiewak now.
Double whammy is a bad thing.
Very good. We're going to take a break. We will come back with more fun and more thrills. You are listening to the Mike O'Mara Show Cocktail Party. Now with King's Things, here's Larry. Sometimes I FaceTime with myself. 9 times out of 10, I have mustard on my shirt. Let's bring back Night Court. Funny boy. Kosher pickles and whole milk. Game changer. Too many children, right? Gonorrhea. Not my problem. If you want funny, you want the TMOS bonus show. Go to MichaelMarysShow.com. Use your mouse. Buy it. It's good, okay? Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show, brought to you by Zappos, Larry. Hey, all you cool cats and kittens.
Yeah.
You know, it's tough to run a private zoo and still have time to look your best. Did you watch it last night?
Oh, my God, Joe Exotic?
Only yes. 4 episodes, Mike.
Yes. Robin Exotic.
Oh, my God. We'll talk about it in a second here. In between hosting your internet TV show and feeding hundreds of big cats.
Big cats.
Your time is super valuable. Your gift shop is a great place to buy lotions and lubricants, both for him and her. But if you really want to look your best, you need Zappos. For example, if you're preparing to sit down for a long-form interview about your polyamorous husband, you certainly don't want to do it shirtless, do you? Of course not. What you need is a nice outfit that allows for style, comfort, and a holster for your gun. I didn't even think of that part. Zappos has your dream wardrobe because Zappos rocks. This is the 20th year that Zappos continues to offer over 1,000 trusted brand names to help millions of customers create a long-lasting wardrobe. Zappos.com. Check them out. We love them. You'll love them, too. Fantastic.
That show, Mike. That show.
Yeah. We'll take some calls right after we talk about this. We watched it. So I welcome your views on this little
program. You go first.
I think the crazy thing is that obviously the star of it, Joe exotic. He's a nutcase, but everyone within his arm's reach is exotic and crazy. And even the guy that he says that his like is his model, the guy that was riding the elephant down the street that seems to be like a little more together, he's a nutcase. And then there's the lady that fed her ex-husband to tigers.
Carol.
I love that. I mean,
yeah, and we don't know whether they're all... like they have levels of despicableness that are stunning to watch, and they are a land of misfits. These people that breed and keep these giant lions and tigers,
and also bears.
It has to be said that there is an amazing amount of credit that goes to the filmmaker. Like when you're interviewing the lady that lost her arm, she is apparently sitting in a dumpster when she does her interview.
Oh, amazing.
It's just amazing. It's you can't turn away.
Mike, if you don't mind, for me, it felt like somebody on Lego Masters decided to build a show so they could decide. They said, hey, why don't you put a dragon and a tiger and asexual, multisexual, polyamorous, do everything you can so when a pandemic comes, that's all they have, but they're satiated.
Yeah.
You can completely escape.
Yeah.
The Tiger King is the name of the show on Netflix.
When he walks into the gift shop and he says, hey, I want to tell you before you hear it on the news, someone lost their arm today, so if you want a rain check, and I'm just like, that's how he handles it?
Oh, the drama queen of the drama queens. I mean, literally, he had to be part of all of it. And if you want an escape from all of this crap, into this show.
I just don't want the glass to get dry.
Can I see your bottle? Can I see your bottle again?
We see the bottle.
Let's see your bottle.
I think we've hit half.
Oh, you could do better than that, Rob.
Got another show to do, Carla.
Jeez.
Another hour. He'll be. But did somebody text me again? What's going on?
Yeah, whose text is on, by the way?
Michael Colburn.
Joe Exotic.
Don't forget the Florida drug lord.
That's a swerve.
Also, what about... I met a guy that runs the ammo department of Walmart. I want him to be the campaign manager for my presidential campaign.
When he runs for governor in Oklahoma.
Who in 2020 says, look, I was there when they sawed off his head, but I wasn't going to tell the judge that I didn't actually saw off his head.
Stunning. And those guys are still walking around out there. Let's take a couple more calls, and then we got to get out of here, and we will roll this into our next hour, and we'll do it.
Which will be live.
So it'll be there. Hello, this is the Mike O'Mara Show. Who are you, and where are you calling from?
Hello, I'm Kathleen.
Hi, Kathleen. Where are you calling from?
Rocky Mount, North Carolina.
How are you, and how you doing in North Carolina?
I am good. It is rough in North Carolina. I'm not going to lie.
It's rough, she says.
Yes.
Okay. What's happening where you are right now? Do you have a shelter in place or anything?
We do.
It's severe like that?
We just got called. North Carolina just got called at 4 o'clock this evening for a shelter in place. So
are you coping?
I've not left the house for about 2 weeks. I have a toddler.
Are you enjoying an adult beverage? Let me try that again. I said, we're doing another hour of this.
So she sounds like us. We haven't really left the house either for 2 weeks. We've taken bike rides and like mini walks
and been together every day.
Yeah.
We've been together every day and we have taken walks around the neighborhood and it's fucking driving us crazy.
Yeah. So. Yeah. Recently, like the last 2 days, it's been pretty bad.
Well, you know what? We're going to be doing these cocktail parties for the foreseeable future. They're good for our sanity and hopefully they're good for yours too. And what's your baby's name?
An interloper.
Look who it is.
His name is Thornton.
Thornton, well, guess what? We have an interloper on our show right now. Come on
up
here.
Hi, little guy.
Hi.
Hi, there's Michael William.
Hi, Michael.
Hi.
Oh, so sweet.
God. He is the sweetest guy.
She just said a lady from North Carolina just called you the sweetest guy.
Oh, he is. He's the best guy. I hope my little guy is like your little guy when he gets that old.
Oh,
that's a compliment. That's sweet. What do you say to a compliment?
Thank you.
Anything you'd like to say to Mr. Rob or Mr. Oscar or Shannon? Would you like to say anything to those guys right there?
No.
Okay, would you like to go back and play your Lego video game?
Uh-huh.
All right. Do you want to say, do you have any message? Do you have any message for the listening audience? Because we got to get out of here. First of all, say goodbye. First of all, say goodbye to the nice lady from North Carolina. Stay safe and stay inside.
Bye.
Okay, my dear.
Up.
Thank
Keep
you. Thank
goodbye.
You. Thank you very much. And now we're going to give you a chance, Michael William O'Mara, to end the first segment of the Mike O'Mara Show. Is there anything you would like to say? You got your signature line. Do you remember what it is?
Goodbye, duty.
Thank you very
much. That's right.
Yes. There
yes.
it is.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Right.
How come that's not playing?
I always say that.
All right. Hold on. Oh, I know why it's not playing.
That's
because
better.
Once again, I put the wrong battery. I'm going to get another charger. Send me another charger.
You know what? There's another charger. We'll get you another charger. We'll back it
Thank
up.
You. Do you have one
charger.
Up there? Do they teach you that there? Do they have one up there?
Hey, Brad.
So how's this going to work? We're going to take a short break, and then we're going to come back
literally less than a five-minute break, and we'll come right back to the live stream.
Right
five
on Facebook
break,
Live.
And, yeah. We will come back. And I'm
Rob, let's see the bottle. Let's see the bottle.
Hold on.
Let's see the bottle from Rob. All right. I got Shannon, let's see the bottle. Let's see the bottle. We got the bottles here. We're going to make it work.
Yes.
Let's see the margaritas, if you don't mind.
Oh, drunk didn't turn the volume
up.
Hey,
way
to go, dumbass. That's great. Only tried to do that 9 times. That's it. See,
it was
9 times. No, it really wasn't your fault. Oh, did you see the look she gave? That's been so much fun, Carla. Really enjoyed doing this first part.
I bet you go to the hardware store again tomorrow.
Yeah.
Mike, we still got calls. If you're on the call, stay on hold. You'll be
yeah,
in the
stay
queue.
On hold. We'll get to your calls when we do the next hour of the
like
Mike O'Mara
Holiday.
Show. Stay there. I'll be right back. For Rob Spiewak and Oscar Santana, Mike O'Mara saying so long. And we'll catch you on the bonus show. Stay with us for another wonderful hour of cocktail party fun.
Bye-bye.
Ciao, ciao.
Thank God it's Friday.
Mike O'Mara, Radio Entertainment.
I'm not sure you even hit a single note. And you know what? It would be a challenge to actually find someone who could sing worse than you.
Have you by any chance lost your kitty?
Okay, let's put an end to this pathetic hoedown.
Pizza, pizza.